Mike. Hello, Mike. Okay, I'm going to see if I can. Ooh, I'm loud, James. Why am I so loud? Okay, I'm going to see if I'm live yet. Mine still does not give me an option. See, they done away with it. If I go to share, watch party's gone.
Yeah, mine was at the top.
Well, I tell you what I'll do. I'll just share it. It worked all right this morning, I guess. But I like doing watch party. I'm going to have to maybe reboot this phone. Maybe that'll help. Maybe there's something going on there. I don't know. Well, let's get in the Word first, okay? Turn with me to Romans chapter 8. And then we'll share a few things. Romans chapter 8. I'll read it out of the Amplified Bible, but I'll also read it out of King James too. Romans chapter 8, verse 29. King James Version says, "For whom he did foreknow, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that we might be firstborn among many brethren." Amplified, "For those whom he foreknew, of whom he was aware and loved beforehand, he also disdained from the beginning to be molded into the image of his Son and share inwardly his likeness." Amplified. Amen. You know, as a believer, you're destined to be molded into the image of Jesus. I mean, that's our whole goal. He says, "Imitate me. You know, do as I did." He was our example. Everything about him. And yet you'll have people tell you all the time, "Oh, you just think you're Jesus." I'm trying my best to get there. Oh, bless God. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that's what it's all about. I mean, he walked a sinless life. Wouldn't that be something to attain? You know, and I'm picking on up on where, what we ministered on this morning, literally. So, you know, God's supernatural power began that process when? The moment you and I got born again, changing us into the image of Christ. And, you know, there's a key to it. Guess what? Guess who holds the key? You and I. You can go as far as you want to in this thing, or you can hold back and decide, "No, I'm going to be me." Yeah. So you are changed on the inside instantly that you get born again. So how successful you are in allowing this change to progress to the outer man is mostly up to you and I, nobody else. Amen. And that's the truth. We grow up spiritually just like we grow up. I mean, we grow up spiritually just like we grow up physically. Just a little bit at a time. You just keep growing, keep growing, keep growing. There's a lot of people they've told me. They believe it. They think we're all full-grown Christians the moment you get born again. No, you're not. There's too many examples in the Bible where it tells us to grow up in the things of God. There's a growing process. Amen? There's certainly a growing process when it comes to holiness. Holiness is where you live in a life without sin. You can get holier and holier the more you win that battle and overcome the areas of the flesh and stuff. Amen. And that's what we're supposed to be after. So what can you do to speed the growing process along? Amen. Spend more time pursuing the things of the Spirit than you spend pursuing the things of the flesh. Amen. I think it's Colossians chapter 3. Yeah, Colossians chapter 3, verse 1. If ye then are risen with Christ, how many of you know you was risen with Christ? If you're born again, you're risen with Him. Amen. You're His body, and when He was risen, we're with that, no matter when you got born again. Seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above and not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with Him in glory. But set your affection on things not of the earth. Amen. Got to understand, too, everything that you and I see here on this planet, it was all birthed in the spirit realm. It was in the spirit realm first before it came over into this natural realm. Okay? And when you understand that, and then you start setting your affections on spiritual things, they, in turn, very soon as you do that, will manifest in this natural realm for you. That's how we obtain the promises of God. You first obtain it in the spirit realm by faith. It's calling those things which be not as though they were. Amen. So don't dare go around saying what you got. Go around saying what God says about your situation or whatever. Yeah, call it. You don't step outside and say, you know, when you're calling your dog to come get fed, and you walk out and you don't see the dog. A lot of people say, well, you got to call it like it is. You go out and the dog ain't there. Well, he's gone. I can't feed him today. Go on inside. No, you go out there even when you don't see him. Here, Pooch. Here. Come on. It ain't long. Here he comes. He knows what you're calling him for. So call those things in. Call those things in. Amen. Let's see. Spend more time pursuing the things of the Spirit than you spend pursuing the things of the flesh or earthly things. There was another scripture that I wanted to look up, and I didn't look it up. But y'all know the scripture over there where it talks about being in love with the world is enmity to God and the things of the world. The things of the world will drag you down from your relationship with God. We all know that. You'll put things that you love and admire to do and attain to do here on this in the earthly realm, you start putting those before God, and you're creating an idol and putting that before God, and God says He don't like that. Amen. So you have to be careful concerning these things. Become dedicated to the Word of God and to fellowship with Him. Be willing to pull aside from every busy thing of life and get alone with Him so He can guide you, teach you, and share His likeness with you and transform you into His image. Have you ever noticed that if you spend time around people who have strong personalities, you automatically are affected by them? You are. You absolutely are. You can be one of those kind of people that when you walk into an atmosphere that, and you sense it, that this ain't all that grand, and you can change that atmosphere. Go in there and literally change it by your countenance and by the words you speak, and bring God in there with you, and you'll be amazed how people will look at you. You can change it. You'll find yourself doing the things they do even. You ever notice that? Their mannerisms will rub off on you. You can't help it. I've seen it many times. They just influence you, especially if they are a people who you respect and admire. Yep, they've watched too many Dallas's on TV or something. I don't know what they watched. Y'all know? Did y'all know Dallas was one of the most influential shows ever created? Yeah. Oh Lord. Here in Proverbs 27:17, it says, iron sharpeneth iron, so a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friends. Woo! Think about it. Amen. When I was a youth minister, let me go to this one. When I was a youth minister, I used to tell this all the time to the young people because they, for whatever reason, I don't know, they just didn't believe me, I guess. But in 1 Corinthians, I don't have the NIV right here in front of me, so I'm going to read it out of this. 1 Corinthians 15:33, it says, be not deceived, evil communications corrupt good manners. The NIV, James, have you got the NIV? The NIV reads, don't be misled, bad company corrupts good character. Who you hang with has everything in the world to do with how you will come out in this life. You hang out with the wrong people, bad people, eat. You're heading for trouble. You are heading for trouble. Proverbs 13:20. And here again, I think NIV reads a little different. 13:20. He that walketh with the wise men shall be wise. But a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Yeah, that's the NIV. He who walks with wise grows wise, but the companion of fools suffers harm. You can't get around the Word of God and the people that influence you and stuff in life. And I learned that a long time ago. I had a friend of mine. When we were growing up, he actually lived with me for just a little while. And he got mad at his mom, and I was living over in a trailer park, and he decided to come move in with me because him and his mom got into it one time. But at the time, he was buying used cars and reselling them some. He had a good job, but he was just doing that on the side and was making big money. And the thing that tickled me, I started asking him, I said, how are you doing all this? Where'd you get the money to go purchase a car? He said, well, I had to bite the bullet on the first one. And he said, but really and truly, he told me about this man that lived in Forestdale, and he said he told him this, and this man was a millionaire. So he went to this millionaire and asked, you know, how do I get going on this? He said, whatever you do, don't go buy that car with your own money. Go buy that car with the bank's money. That way, if they come repossess it, it's the bank that loses. Hurt your credit a little bit. You can always get your credit rating back over the years. And he started doing it. He started making bucks. I mean, but he had to put some work into it, too. But it was amazing. And But, you know, you can go to the bookstore and you can go buy all these books and everything, these called self-help books, who are written by millionaires and billionaires and different things like that. And a lot of them will do you a lot of good because you start thinking like they think. And if you walk with wise men, you'll become wise. In other words, for goodness sakes, don't you ever go to some old guy living out on the street and ask for advice on how to live successfully in life. You wouldn't do it for the man on the moon. Uh-uh. You go to somebody that's successful, don't you? Give me some advice on me. Or to ask some counselor who's never even been married about marriage. First thing I'm going to ask him, who are you married to? And if they're not married, I say, I don't need to listen to you because you've never experienced it. You can say what you want, but you ain't never experienced it. And for goodness sakes, if there's something in the Word of God that you don't understand, you know, and you know that this particular church that you think of, well, I'm going to go ask that bunch down there. Maybe that pastor can help me. We'll give you an example. Baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in other tongues. How many of you know you don't go down the street to the Baptist church and other denominations and ask concerning that gift? They don't operate in that gift. They know nothing about that gift. They cannot lead you into that gift because they don't even have that gift. They've never accepted it. Oh, sure, they'll tell you, well, sure, we believe it. Well, do you operate in it? No, that was for them people back then. That's what they're going to tell you. No, it's for you today. Is it for tongues is for this dispensation. No other dispensation ever had it except this one, the church age that we're living in. Amen. And for goodness sake, would you go? Now, I'm thinking of somebody. You're going to get this. Would you go to a veterinarian if you was having issues with your health? Don't go do that. He can't help you in nothing. I mean, I know they study a lot, and there's a lot of what they do know that's an animal's system is, you know, generally speaking, operates like ours, but still. So there's got to be some wisdom. And who you go to and who you get advice and stuff makes a difference. It makes a difference in life. Amen. So now I'm going to change gears and we're going to finish up with this. The same thing is true with your relationship with God. If you spend enough time with Him, He's going to rub off on you. You know why most Christians can't tell you anything about their Christian walk or the Christianity? They've never spent time with their Heavenly Father. They don't know it. I remember when my mother passed away and I was in a denominational church. And I asked, I said, you know, I just don't understand this. I told them, I said, I don't get it. I don't know why people die at an early age and everything, and they all just loved on me and everything. And said, we don't understand why God takes some of His children home early. We don't get it. And I thought, all they just told me was God killed my mom. God's not the killer. He's the giver of life. And I said, boy, I said, I just don't want to serve your God. He's a mean old critter. He's out killing his own children. And no, how many of you know not everybody is a child of God? Until you get born again, you're a child of the devil. We're of our father, the devil. That's why we need a Savior. Not everybody is a child of God. Don't dare let somebody tell you that because you'll get misconstrued of what's going on out there in the world big time. Thinking along those lines. Not just God created everybody. But not everybody's a child of God. It's just a fact. His ways will become our ways. the more we spend time with Him. Spend time with Him. So make yourself available to Him by praying in the Spirit, worshiping Him, loving on Him, hanging out with Him. I don't care where you're at work or whatever. Hang out with Him. Talk to Him as you go along through your day. He's just sitting there wanting to talk to you. You'll be amazed what He'll tell you to do that you'll just get so tickled at and laugh at and think, my goodness, you know. If I'd hung around you a little bit, I'd been laughing all day. You know, God has a sense of humor even. Amen. Hang around His Word and the people who love His Word. And live it. These are all choices that you have to make in life. You know, it's sad that many of the young people who were raised in church and everything, they make a decision, they want to go hang out with the rebels and the wrong and stuff. And it's not long. They'll be acting just like them. Raised in church and everything else, but it ain't no time at all. They'll be acting just like them. It's amazing. But before you know it, you'll begin noticing yourself changing from the inside out. You'll find your character becoming more like His. You'll see somebody hurting, and you'll know why they're hurting. They're either abusing drugs or in sin real deep, where you used to judge them a little bit. You know, well, he's just going to go out and do it again. After a while, you start having this heart of compassion. You're going, man, that dude just needs Jesus. Get him through that. It'll change your character. It'll change the way you think about things. The more you spend around him, you'll begin to think like he does and talk like he does and even act like he does. His image will begin to shine forth in you. And that's what we're supposed to do as Christians. Amen. One last scripture, 1 Corinthians chapter 3. I ain't read this one, have I? No. Starting in verse 5. Who then is Paul, and who is Apollos, but ministers by whom ye believed, even as the Lord gave to every man? I have planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. So then neither is he that planteth anything, neither he that watereth, but God that giveth the increase. Now he that planteth and he that watereth are one, and every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. For we are co-laborers together with God. Ye are Christ's husbandry. Ye are God's building. According to the grace of God which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth thereon. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereupon. For other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Christ Jesus. Now if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, and stubble, this man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. If a man's work abide which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. How many of you know God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him? If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss. But he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seemeth to be wise in this world, let him become a fool that he may be wise. Amen. Do you realize everything you and I do in this flesh, in this natural life, is going to be judged by fire? Everything. And when that fire of God hits us as we stand before God, and anything that you and I build in our own accord or in our own flesh and this, that, and the other is nothing but stubble and hay, it's going to burn up. And you're going to suffer the loss of it. But everything you and I do for the kingdom of God, every person that you and I reach out to and encourage in the things of God and love on and share Christ with them, I don't care if they get born again or not. It's the ministry of Jesus Christ. It's the image of Christ that we're supposed to present to people. God, when that fire hits that, that's what's left. And you'll receive a reward for what it is you've done. Amen. And the Bible talks about we'll cast our rewards at His feet in that day that we stand before Him. Amen. But believe me, no matter what you think about life and what you accomplish in life, all these things that people have done, sports figures and all that, nobody's going to know a thing about it when we stand before God Almighty. They may be the greatest athlete on the planet. Great gifts that God gave them, great abilities, everything. But it's all going to burn up because it's their accomplishment. Only thing that matters is what we do for the kingdom of God. And if you want to do something for the kingdom of God, you better be in this Word. Amen. And you better hang out with Jesus a little bit and get to know Him and our Heavenly Father. Only then will you be able to do those any of those things. Amen. In closing out this evening, I just want to make a general altar call, mainly if there is anybody watching online or on Facebook, live stream and stuff. If you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, I want to give you that opportunity to come into the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ right now. Amen. If you're here, present, you never have, or if you're even watching on Facebook, live stream. Amen. Hallelujah. And if you're here physically and you have a prayer request, whatever the prayer may be, I want to pray with you. The Bible says to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover, whatever the need may be. But one other side of it here too is if you've never made received the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in another tongue, I want to give you that opportunity here. You don't, whether you're here or live on live stream, you can receive it right now. But if you're here, I'm just going to lay hands on you. If you're here and you want it, I'll lay hands on you. You'll receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You do? Okay, come up here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask both of you a question. Hallelujah. I'm going to leave this live, James, just for a minute. When I lay hands on you, what's going to happen? The Holy Ghost is going to come upon you. And what I want you to do, you may notice a word or a syllable here in your down in your spirit, not up here. And I want you to open your mouth. When I lay hands on, the Holy Ghost is going to come upon you. I want you to open your mouth. And I'm going to help you along. I'm going to be praying in the Holy Ghost too. And you just speak whatever it is that's right down there. And let me tell you before we go there, it may just sound like baby guru. It may just be, speak it out. It'll begin flowing more and more as the more you do it. Okay? But do not speak in English. Do not speak in a language that you know. It's going to be a heavenly language that comes out of your lips. You just let it escape out of your lips, okay? Now, this is going to happen on you when I lay hands on you. Now, has everybody come for it? Okay, stand behind them. Okay? Now, I may need some help from some others, if you know, just to kind of help along here in just a minute. But we're going to take our time here and let it go. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that this, your daughter, a child of the living God, Father God, has asked for the infilling of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in other tongues. And I thank you right now as I lay hands on her, Father God, that she'll begin to speak and the Holy Ghost will come upon her in the name of Jesus. Begin to speak. Just keep praying with her. Father, I thank you for her right now in the name of Jesus, and I thank you that the Holy Ghost is coming upon her and that she will receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in other tongues right now. Holy Spirit, fill her right now in the name of Jesus. Begin to speak. Just let whatever down in your spirit come on out. We thank you, Father God, for filling him right now and giving him his gift, his prayer language right now in the name of Jesus. It is not a feeling. It is not a feeling, but it's just letting the Holy Spirit have your tongue. Shondo lebranga abdele gigi shavrando sode he shambrongo da de sambarede he dando de alembre gigi shavrando oh la 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 mania sode di shambre gigi shando do do da brendi coro vro do do de oh rende abare di sondo do do de sambambono de chi shala lo ho do de sande shavrami chi shana do coro da ivramodo speak. Just go ahead and speak. Let him have it. Ondo onde esavra mahase salandorone. Onde kisha la la gamrande hikedededede. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Father God, that the Holy Ghost is on them right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Oh, we're just going to take our time. Take our time. Oh, it may just be one syllable that comes out of your mouth. It may just be one syllable. It may be, ooh, ooh, ooh. Just say it. Just say it. Just say it. Just say it. Onde hishinkando so rambo. Hibrama sandevindo so do de shivrambo. Oh, la la le kishavrando remikita noke. Kera brandi sivrando de himranga se shasa sondo nia le brandi viria sohuko. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, nia de sedi nivrando sodo. Praise the name of Jesus. Sokora nekema handa kase sisi. Just let it come out your lips. All the money, whatever it is. So de nama, shonde nama, hasanda, londe misim bodo koba sisi. Praise you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Oh, shalagamba sisi. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead. Hallelujah. Shombo morini dandi vramba hakasisisi. Kandisha lando rondo dosele kedede. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. Oh, danani di vrambodo. Oh, danada. Pandari. Say, speak. Keep going. Keep going. Shombo hokande kikika lavrambo. De shani dandan lele vrande sodo donde. Oh, nambre. Oh, la 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 ya shone re re. Kamba no de hankande si sala kevrando desha. Om rangi shavram mike dandando koko brade. Eh, masandoro. Oh, nede simon de lele le rondo su pade ke shala la tesisi. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Onde chi savrimme te ta da te no cote. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, every one of you, you experienced the Holy Ghost coming upon you. You experienced it totally different than she experienced it, and she experienced it totally different than she experienced it. Amen? And you may be thinking to yourself right now, well, I never really spoke in tongues right there, but if you spoke something out, I didn't get to hear anything. My hearing's not the best anyway, but if you spoke something out, that was the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in other tongues. The evidence of that infilling was you speaking in tongues. Tongues is not the Holy Ghost, okay? But if you'll continue when you're off alone by yourself, just let that come up. Don't stop. Just keep praying. Just keep speaking it, and your prayer language will develop. When we learned how to speak English, it took a while to learn how to speak English. Just ask your parents. And it's the same with that, okay? But I will tell you this. The devil will come to you this very night and tell you right now that you did not receive anything when you came up to this altar. Because he's a liar and he's the father of all lies. That's all he can do is lie to you. You just put your foot down and say, oh, yes, I did. Okay? You just put your foot down and say, oh, yes, I did, you lying devil. You get out of here. I am now filled with the Holy Ghost. And I speak in tongues as evidence of that infilling. Okay? And don't you let nobody talk you out of it. No devil in hell or man on earth. Okay? And I'm going to tell you, you just stepped into the second most powerful thing that can ever happen to you as a born-again Christian. The first thing that ever happened to you is the most powerful is when you got born again. There's nothing more powerful on this planet than that taking place in your life. But this is second to it. This is the second part of it. You just became grand enemy of the devil. Because now he knows he can't stop you ever. He can't stop you because you have the capability of now speaking in a language, whether it's a language of the earth or a heavenly language. How many of you know, angels don't speak earthly languages. And there's thousands upon thousands, if not millions upon millions of different languages that angels speak. You may speak one of them. Okay? And the longer, I will tell you this, the longer you do pray in the Spirit and continue in it and not quit, the more you'll find yourself changing languages all the time. It'll happen. And he may use you in speaking languages here on this earth some. But whatever it is, don't stop. If it sounds like baby guru, just ba 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 ba, just do it. The next thing you know, you'll be going la 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 along with it with ba 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 ba. And next thing you know, it's shambrando kovra masima rekorda resiva bahasol. And then it goes on from there more and more and more. It's nonstop. And you'll receive from this gift. You may be pretty bold right before you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Or you may have been a little timid, a little shy at sharing your faith with somebody. I'm going to tell you, you will experience a boldness of the Holy Spirit like you've never experienced in your life. You'll be in a crowd and you hear somebody saying something, you're going, that just ain't right. And you just say, well, you know, that's just not right. And you'll have a boldness not to attack, but to walk in love and say, you know, God don't want you going through that. That's not true what you just said. That's what the baptism of the Holy Ghost is all about. Is giving you, it empowers you to be the witness that God has destined you and called you to be. You can't do it without this gift. And not only that, this is the entrance gift to all the other gifts. Now God will even begin using you as you learn to yield to Him in tongues, interpretation of tongues in a public setting, prophecy, word of wisdom, word of knowledge, working of miracles, healings, the gifts of healings. God may start pouring out through you any of these other gifts now, more so than ever. And if you ever get in a bind, if you ever get in a place and you say, I don't know what to do. I don't even know how to pray concerning this. Shondo kibranga masima hotode is how you pray. You pray in the Holy Spirit. And when you're praying in the Holy Spirit, your flesh and your mind has nothing to do with it. They're not connected to it. It's coming from your spirit, and you are speaking the language of God directly to God, and God is praying His perfect will through you concerning whatever situation it is. You're the most powerful thing walking on the earth right now. Because you are now able to walk in that, and you can pray the perfect will of God, and your flesh don't have to get involved, and your mind don't have to get involved. You just let Him pray it through you. Your life is going to be different. You just stepped into the biggest adventure that you've ever dreamed of. But I warn you, there's a devil out there that will tell you, no, you didn't. That wasn't nothing but a bunch of junk. And it may come from good people that you love and admire. It may come from other believers even. Just don't let no man on earth and no devil in hell talk you out of it. You just remind them here, what's today, 25th? Yes. Here on the 25th of October 2020, right in the middle of the biggest pandemic in the world has ever known, I got filled with the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in other tongues. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank y'all. Glory to God. That's exciting, y'all. I can't tell you how exciting that is. Amen. So let me finish up, James, and we'll get off this. Just a few things. We can have 10 minutes if that's all right with everybody. James, can you pull up my video? But you got to get us offline first, I guess. Hallelujah. And if you need any help concerning answering questions, I don't know that I can answer them, but anybody in this room will be happy to share things with you.